Over the years, landslides have buried alive several people living on the slopes of Mount Elgon, with the recent incidents being the Mbale and Kasese floods, where over 50 people lost lives and scores were left homeless. Unfortunately, the increasing number of fatalities resulting from landslides has not stopped people from settling there. Cabinet has resolved to evacuate all people settled in the high-risk areas.
With the people, that those who live in these slopes, please find a way of shifting from those risky areas, particularly if you have land, because you find people have different plots of land and some of the land they have is in safer areas. Please shift and relocate.
A team of environmental experts has been dispatched to sensitize people on the process. This team will also do the mapping of all areas to be vacated, starting with those in the mountainous areas of Kasese, Bugishu, Sebei and Rwenzori regions. After they have been evacuated, Honorable Chris Badiomonsi says the areas will be gazetted as national parks or taken over by the government to grow trees.
We'll send a team of our physical planners, environmentalists, human settlement officers to educate the people on the ground and maybe even to mark the areas which are high risk, and then we are going to gazette these areas where we wouldn't want to have people keep staying there.
But Yumonsi says people will identify land within their districts and the government will facilitate their relocation.
We have enough money for the resettlement and relocation. Money will never be enough, but we have to start. And we are going to start with the area of Bugisu. Actually, there is an NGO, Give Directly, that is working with the government that has already started providing facilitation to some of the families to do the relocation, and we're also going to mobilize money from within the government budget to support the exercise.
In other developments, Cabinet has set August 24th to 25th, 2023 as the dates for the National Housing and Population Census. The exercise will cost over 300 billion shillings.
This exercise is usually carried out in a period of time, so the budget is usually spread. So the budgetary estimates that we are working with, about 330 billion shillings, but spread in a period of 5 years. Some of the money has already been spent for the activities which you carry out before, but the major expenditure shall be this financial year and next financial year, those 2 years. But usually the activities start much earlier.
The Uganda National Bureau of Statistics usually carries out a census every 10 years, with the last census having been carried out in 2014. Report by Jaliet Namwaya for the news.